So hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and if you're new, welcome. I'm Gleens, and you guys, in this video I'm going to show you how you can shape some short nails, some short square nails. Some people really think that short nails are really easy to shape, but it's not. So I will give you guys in this video some tips and tricks how you can shape short nails as nice as you can, square, nice, you know, clean nails. I will show you that in this video, but before you go ahead and watch this video, go on my social media account. I will put them here in the screen so you can go ahead and show me some love. And before you go ahead and watch this video, comment in the comment section below what you would like to see me cream nail it. If you didn't heard about it yet, I am going to start a series where I'm going to cream nail every object, random objects. I'm going to create it like encapsulated in the nails. I'm going to do an inspired set about it, everything. It can be everything, like random objects. It can be a pen, it can be a random objects. Comment in the comment section below so you can help me pick some random objects for this series. So I'm so excited about it. I just want to know what you guys would like to see me encapsulate or recreate or cream-nail it in this series. So don't forget to comment in the comment section below what you would like to see me cream-nail, and then let's go ahead and watch this video. So I thought I was filming, but I wasn't filming. I'm sorry you guys, so I don't have the pinky on footage, but I will start on the ring finger, and I've already got the autocrylic off, and I've already prepped the nails and also applied a thin layer of clear acrylic. And now I'm going to apply this color. I'm going to apply this kind of red burgundy kind of color. This is a color that I've got from Curacao when I was on vacation, so I don't have a direct link for you guys, I'm sorry. But the first thing that you have to start with to get a perfect square shape is to start with your base. So your nails have to be like shaped the correct shape first before you are going to apply your acrylic. So most of the times when you're going to apply your acrylic, the nail can look more wider than it is, or I mean your base, it can look wider than the base of the nail. So that's why I always like to shape my nails a little bit smaller than I would like it to be, because when you're going to apply the acrylic, it will be a little bit wider, and we don't want wide nails. We are going to achieve that's perfect square nails. So make sure you use your hand file, and make sure it's a sturdy hand file so it won't bend when you're going to file the sides of the nail. Make sure you file the sides of your nail as straight as you can, and if you can, a little bit smaller than you would like to be, a little bit slimmer than you would like it to be, because when we are going to apply the acrylic, it will be a little bit wider. But next to the application, as you guys can see, I already have some videos on how to apply acrylic. I will put those links for you guys in the description box below. But when you're going to apply the acrylic to keep your shape as good as you can, so the shape will not be too wide, you will just have to use your brush and make sure you swipe it at the sides to make your acrylic application as neat as you can, so it won't be too wide, so you don't have to file too much. So I'm going to show you and talk through on the next nail that I'm going to do. That's gonna be the index finger. And yeah, I'm just going to show you that on the index finger what you exactly have to do. So I'm going to apply the colored acrylic first, and I'm pointing the nail downwards. As you guys know, I like to point my nail downwards so the acrylic goes downwards and won't run into the cuticle area. And don't forget to use your flat brush to dab into the cuticle area, as close as you can to the cuticle area, and dab your acrylic, your brush at the sides, dab it at the free edge, dab it at the sides,
and make it as slim as you can. And then we are going to encapsulate the whole entire nail with some clear acrylic and also swipe, swipe, swipe at the sides and dab, dab, dab at the free edge of the nail. So that's what I'm going to do on all the 10 nails, and then I will come back and we are going to file these babies. I think that you're still watching, and if you're still watching, thank you so much for watching my videos. I really appreciate it. Go ahead and subscribe to my channel if you're watching and you're not subscribed yet. Go ahead and subscribe to my channel, and if you're still here watching, comment a red hearted emoji in the comment section below so I know that you're still here. And the word that I'm going to teach you guys today from my language Papiamento will be cortico, and cortico means short. So this is how the nails look after application, and next I'm going in with my medium grit from Cupa. I will put the link for you guys in the description box below. And as you can see, I just file. I have a video on how I do that exactly, and how I use my e-file. But as you can see, I just go with my bit at the sides to get it as slim as possible. So I don't like wide nails, and short nails can get really wide really fast without, you know, if you don't shape it well, you can really see fast at short nails that it's not well shaped. So go with your e-file, hold your e-file straight at the sides. As you can see, I'm going straight, I'm holding it straight to the side of the nail so I can get a straight line, or I mean a straight nail shape. So that's what I'm doing, as you can see, and just going on the surface of the nail. I'm not going into the cuticle because we will file too much at the cuticle area, and we don't want that. So I will go in with my tapered bit into the cuticle area to smooth down the cuticle area and make it as flat as we can, but also neat and, you know, nice nail, short nail shapes. Thank you. So now I'm going in with the tapered bit into the cuticle area. So now I'm going in with my hand file to perfect the shape, and this is actually the same step that you would have to do before applying the acrylic. Shape it as slim as you can at the sides and make sure you use a hand file that's sturdy, that will not bend, because your shapes, your side of the nails will not be as sharp as you would like to. So especially for beginners, make sure you have a sturdy hand file. These I also got from Curacao, so I don't have a link for you guys, but I think in your local dollar shop or some in your nail shop, you can just go and find some of these sturdy nail files. Most of the times they are square. I like these square nail files, and these work the best for me, but I couldn't find these here in the Netherlands, or I don't know, I didn't look for them online. But yeah, that's unfortunate. But as I told you guys before, I'm just going in with my hand file at the sides. Make sure you hold your file as straight as you can. You want to shape the nails as square and as straight as you can. So that's what I'm going to do. And also at the free edge, I also want a sharp, nice looking nail. This client liked me to like bump the free edge a little bit, so that's I'm going to do that at the end of the video. You will not see me do that, I think, on footage, but I will just bump it just a little bit to give her a more natural look instead of square shape. I personally like the nails square and sharp, but she like her nails a little bumpy, just a little bit, to give it a more natural look. So that's what I'm going to do at the end of the video. But when I'm done filing from this angle, I always like to watch my nails from this angle to see if it's straight. And I think actually I'm now bumping the nail a little bit from this angle to see if it's straight from my side and also from the client's view. So also check, always check your nails from this side, and after I'm done doing that, I'm going in with a puffer and I will clean the nails with some alcohol, and then I will show you guys how I apply the gel top coat and cure it for 2 minutes under my lamp. So now I'm applying the gel top coat from Case Ink Nails on all the 10 nails, and I'm curing it for 2 minutes under my lamp to make sure it's properly cured, and then I will show you guys the end result. So this is the end result, you guys. This is how the nails look after curing them under my lamp for 2 minutes and applying some cuticle oil love, love, love the end result. I love me some clean short nails. I love actually all kind of nail designs. Let me know in the comments below what you would like to see in my next videos.
So yeah, you guys, this is the end of the video. Thanks so much for watching. I really hope you have liked this video. I really hope you have learned something. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on the post notification bell so you're the first one to know when I post the next time and when you post the new episode of Cree Nail. And you know, subscribe to my channel if you're not subscribed here, so you also can see my Cree Nail episode, okay? Okay. subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for subscribing and share this video with everybody, with your family and friends, your mother, your dad, you know, everybody. Share this video and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye bye.